so much, New Orleans. Thank you, guys. How are you? Good? Awesome. So good to be here. I've been traveling a lot, so it's nice to be on the ground. Oh, you have no idea. I have a horrible fear of flying. I really do. You've heard me on planes before. I'm that person in the back that you hear as soon as that little pocket of turbulence hits, that person. And you're like, oh, I hope she's okay. Yeah, she is me. I am she. That's me in the back, scared. On the ground, I'm a man. Yeah, with you guys, I'm a man. I do manly things, I high five, things like that. Up in the air, I'm a little girl. Because every flight I'm on has turbulence, every one. We came in here yesterday, we spun in sideways. It was crazy, we landed sideways. We like skidded in, I was like, But every single flight I'm on has turbulence, every single one. And now they warn you ahead of time. You know, they'll come on, they'll be like, buckle your seatbelts. The next 10 minutes are gonna be bumpy. I don't take it anymore, guys. I yell shit back. Hey, you pay a lot of money for these seats. Yell back, make your opinion heard. I'll open up the window and look out and go, no, we're not, dude. Pull up and to the left. Try that fucking air out for 10 minutes. Why can't we go there? Nobody has ever explained that to me. Listen, if you were driving here tonight in a car and you were hitting every pothole in the road, could you turn to your friends and be like, oh, it's gonna be like this for the next 10 minutes, guys? Your friends would be like, fuck you, switch lanes. Why can we not switch air lanes? There's no traffic up there. We don't have to worry about it. When's the last time you're on a plane and another one flew right by? You're like, ooh, we should hang out in this lane for a while. These other lanes are occupied. People say, take pills. Oh, everything's a pill. Take a pill. Take a pill. I can't. I have to switch a lot of flights. I need my wits about me. I smoke pot, but you know, that's a thing that you can't really time out. And they don't let you smoke pot on planes. They just don't. What I used to do is I used to eat a pot cookie on the way to the airport. So, you know, by the time the plane took off, it would kick in and my anxiety would be okay. But here's the problem. The pot cookie business is not a regulated industry. There's no quality control whatsoever. Yeah, Nabisco doesn't make pot cookies. I don't know what those Keebler elves were doing in that fucking tree, but if you think anybody would make a pot cookie, it'd be an elf that lived inside of a tree, but they don't, they're lazy. Potheads make pot cookies, so it's not an exact science. Yeah, I've had some before where nothing happened. All I got was chocolate in my teeth. I ate one though, on the way to the airport this one time, that as soon as I ate the cookie, I had that warm sensation come over my body, like, ooh, you just made a bad decision. My wife was driving me to the airport. It was an early flight, like 5:30 in the morning. And as soon as we got in the car, I was listening to the radio and I thought that Katy Perry's Firework was the greatest song in American history. I was like, babe, who wrote this song? This is inspirational. This makes me feel good about myself. And then the paranoia started setting in. I was like, can you just drop me off at the tarmac? Because I don't think I'm gonna be able to handle the building part today. Dumps me off at the curb, staring at the airport like a kid on the first day of school who doesn't really want to go in yet. I'm like, oof. This isn't gonna go well at all. And then I started looking around. I was like, all right, just relax and just do what everyone else is doing. Just be normal. So now I'm walking into the airport and I think I'm saying this to myself, but out loud I'm going, I walk like other people walk. Other people walk like me. And I walk similar to them, similarly. And then I got in, the TSA guy looks right at me and I'm like, oh, he knows everything. He knows I'm high. He knows my hopes and dreams, my dick size, this guy knows it all. Might as well just start air arresting myself right now. There's a part of your brain that stays lucid in these moments. It takes over. It's like, all right, lucid up, idiot. The next 10 minutes are the most important 10 minutes of this trip, bro. Pull your shit together, don't be a pussy. So now there's all the zigzag things you have to walk through. But when there's nobody there, you're just supposed to walk up to the front. No, I'm wheeling my bag through all of them going, I walk like other people walk. And then I look over and the TSA guy is still staring at me. So that I'm like, my brain's like, well, just be nice and smile. So now I'm doing this. Then I got to the TSA guy and I went to high five him. Let me tell you guys something. It was an awkward high five. I had my hands out like this. Don't try to high five a TSA person. They will not reciprocate. Then I handed him my license. He's like, bro, this is your Costco card. I was like, they both have my picture on it. You want to split a pallet of strawberries? I do have to travel a lot to leave my family. I have a wife and we've got two young boys and I made it up to them though. We did a 21-day family vacation, 21 days. Yeah, that's the maximum amount of time you could spend with your family. Oh, in a hotel room, one hotel room, 21 days. I know why the Donner Party ate each other now, I do. Because they were sick of looking at one another. 21 days, and it wasn't a vacation for me. This is my vacation. What all they do on vacation, I just have to move the stuff around. That's it. I am a Sherpa for my kids. That's all I am. You guys know what Sherpas are. Those people that carry rich white people's shit to the top of mountains. Who get no credit whatsoever. Just pack as much stuff up on their backs. There's no editing when it comes to packing. If we need it, just bring it. He'll carry it, sure. You gotta see me getting through an airport. Double strollers, pack in place. Car seats, two of them. Because they're light as a feather, why not? Backpacks, I have backpacks, an Elmo backpack and a dinosaur backpack. And they're filled with food. I don't know what my kids eat. All I know is everywhere we go, they don't fucking have it. So I have to pack it and bring it with me. I have kale hanging out of a backpack. You know what that's like as a man trying to go through an airport, trying to keep my kids in front of me like a hockey goalie? And thank God my wife is there, guys. Thank God. Because who else would carry that heavy Us Weekly magazine and half-drunk bottle of Evian water? Who else would power that through security? Love of my life. And then you get on the plane, and you've never felt hatred. If you don't have kids, you have no idea what hatred feels like. 300 eyes just, oh, don't even look at them. People think that if they don't look at us, we'll just walk off the back of the plane. No. We're there, and I understand. It's a whole thing. We're like one of those Mardi Gras floats coming down the middle, like, beads, people flying stuff, yeah, throwing things at other people. One lady caught eye contact with us, and she just started praying the rosary. She's like, oh God, just keep the Griswolds away from us, please. And bad news, if you're in my row, well, you are now in my family. Welcome to my family. Welcome. Here's a sweater with the family crest on it. Raise your right hand, put the other one in the Us Weekly magazine. We're gonna swear you in. It's a long trip to LAX. Someone has to hold the iPad. The iPad, if you have kids, is the greatest invention in the history of mankind. The best. I love it so much. I would dig Steve Jobs up and I'd suck his dick right now. Yeah. I'd suck a dead guy's dick and accept whatever came into my mouth from the guy. Oh yeah. You have no idea. My son sits on these long, he's 4 years old, long flights, 6 hours. And he plays with puzzles and he draws pictures and he watches movies and then he falls asleep and you can take it to the bathroom and pleasure yourself. Now you find me something that's better. They got Wi-Fi on these planes now, guys. You didn't think I'd put two and two together? Yeah, occupied. Still occupied. What do you think is happening in here?